गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो वी हैव सीन इश्यूज ऑफ मटेरियल फोर मेथड्स. फर्स्ट इज फीफो, नेक्स्ट इज लीफो, देन वी हैव सीन सिंपल एवरेज एंड वेटेड एवरेज. एंड आई आस्क स्टूडेंट्स टू डू होमवर्क. प्लीज डू होमवर्क, अदरवाइज इट विल बी नॉट ईजी टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट. इट सीम्स वेरी इजी, बट वेन यू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम इट गिव्स यू ट्रबल. ओके, सो दिस वी हैव सीन टिल नाउ. So our next concept, this will be asked in exam. So what is that? More points that we are seeing here now. Now sometimes what will happen, the materials will be returned to the vendor. Vendor means to the from the person from whom we are purchasing. Vendor means we can say supplier. We are returning the goods to the supplier. Okay. So what way to write? What to write in the format? Okay. What it says. If any material is returned to vendor, if any material is we are returning to supplier, it is recorded as an issue. So you have to record it as an issue. This is important. Whenever a material is been returned to the store vendor, vendor means supplier, you have to write an issue. The price at which such return is recorded is the rate at which it was purchased. So at which first price you purchased, the same price you have to write at issue. Clear? Easy? Irrespective of the method of pricing being followed. So whatever you method follow, you follow either LIFO method or you follow FIFO method, you follow weighted average or simple average. Okay, so you have to do what you have to write in issue column and the price at which you have purchased. Okay, this return to vendor will be asked only in FIFO and LIFO method. In your exams it will be asked only FIFO and LIFO method. That's it. Okay, so first, whenever you are returning goods to supplier, you have to record that return in issue column, and the price you have to write, right? Unit price. The unit price should be on what date you have purchased, that you have to write. On what date and what amount you have purchased, that you have to write. That is material returned to vendor. Okay, next, when you return materials to stores, when you are returning materials to stores, this is important. This will be asked in exam. You are returning to materials to stores. Stores means the material is being returned to from production department. The material is coming to the stores. Okay, if material is returned to stores by the production department, it is recorded as a receipt. You have to record as receipt at the price at which it is originally issued. Okay, at what price it is issued, at the same price you have to record it. What he is saying, at the price at which it is issued, that same price you have to write here. Okay, and you have to record as receipt. Careful, when you are returning goods to supplier, you have to write as purchase issue column. When the goods are coming from production department to the stores department, you have to write as receipt column, and price will be the originally price it was issued. If no information is provided about the rate at which it was issued, it is assumed that the rate has been return has been issued from the latest issue. So whenever in the problem there is no information, which price at the rate, there will be no information of rate. So what to do? So latest issue will be called, that price we have to take. Latest issue price we have to take. Okay, I'll explain you what is latest issue and all that price we have to take. Okay, next, if the stock from the material returned was earlier issued is not yet exhausted, it can be clubbed with such remaining stock. What he says, if the stock, we are getting some materials, right? If the stock we are got from the department, production department, sorry, stores department, that we have not yet used, so in that case what we have to do, we have to record that as, we have to club that as with remaining stock. Okay, so this or this, from the both, anyone you do. So you ask me, this is easy. This will also I'll show you, this method also I'll show you. Okay, it is normal practice to reissue the materials returned is priority to the existing materials. Okay, the same he is saying. So simple, I'll tell you, very simple. This you follow. What to do, whenever materials are returned to stores, you write as an receipt, and the earlier issue price will be the price. Okay, I'll explain you this latest issue price, how to write that, we I'll explain you. Okay, so we have seen materials returned to vendor, materials returns to store. When we have a material returned to vendor, then we have to record it as an issue, and the latest price will be called as what, and the price at which it purchased, that we have to record as issue price. Okay, next, whenever the materials returned to stores, that you have to return as receipt column, and the price will be the latest issue price. Okay, next, last one, shortage and surplus. This is important, shortage and surplus. If there is any shortage defected on physical stock taking, such shortage is written as an issue. whenever what is happen what will happen I'll tell you. What is shortage? When shortage will come? See, the goods are coming from supplier to stores department. Okay, when the goods has come from the supplier to stores department, the goods are 100 quantity. Let us assume 100 quantity is 100. But after some days, the stores department, the stores ledger, the keeper went and he checked physically. There is only 95 units. At how much he received? 100. How much he is having? 95. What to do in that case? That case he says the shortage is recorded as issue. So you have to write the shortage as issue. Whenever there is a shortage, you have to record as issue. Similarly, a surplus is recorded as a receipt. If any surplus is there, that you have to record as receipt. And the rate is the latest issue price. Same as we do in materials returned to stores, in the same way we have to do. Okay. So here also, when materials are returned to stores, we are writing an issue column. Whenever there is a shortage, you have to write an issue column. Okay. And what will be the price that we have to write? Latest issue price. Here also same latest issue price. Okay. And whenever there is a surplus will be there, then you have to record as receipt. Easy. Very easy. So three methods we have seen. First is material returned to vendor. Simply remember what I'll tell you. Whenever the materials are returned to vendor, what you do, record as an issue, and the price at which purchase, that you have to write here. Next, whenever the materials return to stores, then you have to record that as receipt, and the what will be the price? The latest issue price will be the price you have to record. Next, whenever shortage and surplus, shortage, if there is a shortage, you have to record as the same, you have to write in issue, and the price will be the same latest issue price. Okay, this I'll explain you what is latest issue price, what is, you know, whenever it is was purchased, which it was purchased, I'll explain you when we solve the problem. Easy, very easy. Okay, so there are three methods. 1, 2, 3. One is return to vendor, return to stores, shortage and surplus. Okay, chaliye, you'll understand better when we solve a problem. Okay, so these methods, this return to vendor, supplier, vendor means supplier, stores, and shortage and surplus is only applicable to FIFO and LIFO method that will be asked in exam. Only FIFO and LIFO. Okay, and I want to copy this page number B15. This three materials return to supplier, material returns to stores, shortage and supply. You put heading as return to vendor, comma, stores and shortage and supply. You write like this: materials return to vendor, comma, stores and shortage and supply, surplus. Okay, then you write, copy this 1, 2, 3, materials return to stores from here to here, you write. Then shortage and supply, the entire thing you write. Materials return to vendor also, you from here to here, you have to write. Okay, chaliye, I will do a problem on FIFO method, returns and shortage. So this is asked in exam March, April 2018. Okay, this they have asked in exam. So this is a problem. What he is saying, you see, the following is a summary of receipts and issue of materials in a factory during a month. So in a factory, there are issues and receipts he has given. So let us read first. It is started on 1st January, ending on 31st January. 1st January is what? Opening balance 500 units at rupees 25 each. Okay, we know this. Opening balance. Then 3rd January, they have issued FIFO method we are following. Here it says follow FIFO method. Then again, material received from supplier at 24.5 per unit. Return to supplier, goods purchased on 10th January 20. He says you are returning to supplier. You are returning to supplier. Means you have which column you have to write? Whenever you are returning to supplier, means vendor. I said right, vendor means supplier. You have to write as an issue column. And is clearly mentioning that you have purchased on 10th January. So 10th January, what is the date? What is the price that you have to record? I'll explain you when we solve the problem. Okay. Next, on 20th January, they have issued 180 units. 24th January, again, they purchased 200 units at 25.5 per unit. And again, 25th January, they issued 120 units. And on 26th January, they returned to stores. Now they are returning to stores. Whenever the goods are returned to stores, you record as a receipt. Okay. After receipt on, then what he says, issued on 20 Jan. Where is 20 Jan? This is 20 January. Okay. So this material you are returning to the stores now. Okay. And 20 January, the issue price will see, and that issue price will write here. Okay, so what he says next? A physical verification taken on 22nd January reveals a shortage of 5 units. What he's saying? They have physically checked on 22nd January and they have seen that there is shortage of 5 units. There is a shortage of 5 units. Again, there is a shortage. So shortage, what we are saying? If there is a shortage, what we have to record? If such shortage is recorded as an issue. And what price we have to write? The latest issue price will be the price that we have to record. So in this problem, he has asked us three things. One is what? Goods returned to supplier, return to stores, and a shortage also he has given. Okay, so simple, it's very easy, we can easily solve it. Easy, right? So you keep in your mind, first you should be perfect for FIFO method. Okay, then you should be perfect with this return to supplier, what to do, return to vendor, what to do, and what price should we take. Okay, and when there is a physical verification and there is a shortage, that shortage, where should we record and what price we should record, that is important. Okay, and he is asking you to find out closing inventory on 31st January by using FIFO method. So first we'll do a problem based on FIFO method, then we'll solve a problem on LIFO method. Okay, chali, we'll start solving the problem. It's a very easy to solve. And I know you people are practicing the problems. This chapter you practice. It's very easy to score marks in this chapter. Important is what? Practice you have to do. Chal, let us start solving now. So, heading will be stores ledger. So we will write FIFO method, right? So first is what? Received, then is what? Issue, last is what? Balance. If you want, you can draw a line like this. Okay. So first will be date, then purchase. Even there is no purchase order number in question, you have to write this in format purchase order number. Quantity, unit price, total. Again same, even there is no requisition number in the question, you have to write in the format requisition number, quantity, unit price, total. Quantity, unit price, total. Okay, so this is our format. We know the format. In received we have four columns, and in issue we have four columns. In received we have five columns, in received issue we have four columns, and total column balance we have three columns. We know the format, right? Chali, let us start first. We are having 1st January. We have some opening. So directly we can go to the balance and we can write how many units we are having opening balance. 500 units at rupees 25. So 500 units at 25. You multiply 500 into 25. You will get 12,500. Okay, chali. Next, 3rd January, what you have done? You have issued 250 units. So 3rd January, issue column I'll go, no requisition number. How many units? 250 units. The price will be 25. Okay, so 250 into 25, you'll get 6250. Okay, so the balance will be 12,500. Next, 250 25 6250. Oh my goodness, it's a mistake here. This we should not write. 500 you should not write. Balance from 500 we have issued 250, so the balance is 250 now. Okay, my mistake, shouldn't do mistakes. Chali, next, on 10th January, returned received from supplier 400 units at rupees 24.5 per unit. सो एंड 10th जनवरी दे हैव रिसीव्ड नो परचेज ऑर्डर नंबर 400 यूनिट्स एट रुपीज 24.50 24.50 400 into 24.50 9,800 worth rupees they have received goods on 10th January. So the balance will be you are having 250 with 25 6250 then 400 with 24.50 9800 this is 6000 okay 9800 next what he is saying 15th January return to supplier goods is purchased on 10th January 20 units so date is 15th January what happened on 15th January we are returning goods so you whenever you return goods you have to return record as an issue to supplier you are giving so you have to write an issue how many units he says 20 units okay so let me write 20 units and what is saying which units you are supply returning the units which you have purchased on 10th January 20th January means what this is 10th January what is the price 24.50 24.50 this I am trying to explain you yes see what he says materials returned to vendor if any material is returned to vendor or supplier it is recorded an issue so where we have recorded this is we have recorded in issue and what he is saying the price at which is return such return is recorded is the rate at which what purchased yes at what rate we have purchased on 10th January means 24.50 24.50 this side I am explaining you okay so this is returns let me write here returned to supplier so whenever goods are returned to supplier you have to record in issue column and which price the date on which you have purchased okay so 20 into 2.24.50 getting 490 clear next Return to supplier. Okay, what price? Return to stores. Supplier says and is writing return to stores. He received. Received. No. Now, chale. Now let us write closing now. So the same we'll write here 250, 25, 6250. Which goods we are returning? Which goods we are returning? The goods which we purchased on 10th January. So from 400 you have to take out 20. Okay. But FIFO method, what it says? First in, first out. First in, first out. But first in, first out, it should not follow here FIFO method. Why means this 250 we purchased on, when did we purchase? This is opening balance. 250 is opening balance. But in the problem, he says on 10th January with the goods which you purchased, from that 20 is defective. It has been returned to supplier. And the same price we have taken means we have to deduct from 400 only. Okay. Chali. So from 400, you take out 20. You'll get how much? 380. So 400 minus 20, 380, 24.50. 380 into 24.50. 9310. Okay, 9310. Next, what is next? Again, you issued. When did you issued? 20 January, 180 units. So 20th January, we are issuing. 20th January we are issuing how many units? 180 units. 180 units. Okay. So which method we have to follow? FIFO method. So this first in first out means 180 price we have to take 25. 180 into 25 we are getting 4500. Okay. So from 250 you have issued 180. 250 minus 180 you will be available with the 70. So how did we get 250 minus 180? The price will be 25. 70 into 25 you are getting 1750. Okay, next the same 380 will write here. 380 with 24.50 9310. Okay, chale. Next, what is next date? 20. After 20, 24. Purchased at 200 units. Again on 24th, goods has been purchased on 24th. So let me continue this on 20 other page. 24th, can I write here 24th? In balance, there will be a problem. Let me continue on the other page. So continuation is here. Let me check, we'll get here or not. 24th January. We have received how many units? 200 units at rupees 25.50. 200 into 25.50. 5100. Okay. So the balance will be, first we'll write 70, 25, 1750, 380, 24.50, 9310. And 200, 25.50, 5100. Done. Chali. After 24th, we have 25th. What we have done on 25th? Issued 120 units. 25th. Oh, before that, we have tried shortage. See, why shortage means? Oh my goodness, 24th. Before 24th, we have tried shortage. Before 24th only we have tried shortage. Why means the sequence we have to go. Sequence we have to go. Okay. So this is strike off. I thought of not writing here. So this should not, this will come after shortage. So 22nd is a shortage. We have tried first shortage. 22nd is a shortage first. The shortage, whenever there is a shortage, you have to write in which column? See, whenever there is a shortage, you have to write in issue column. Okay, the shortage. So let me go to the issue column. How much is shortage? 5 units is a shortage. 5 units is a shortage. And which price I have to take? Now, what we have set to the shortage? Latest issue price we are seeing. If any shortage is there, what we have to do? If there is any shortage is there, what we have to do, such shortage should be recorded at issue column. Okay, we are recording in issue column, but the price will be the latest issue price. So see in the latest issue price, latest column, issue price, which is the latest, 25 is the latest. This 25 we have to take. That is called latest issue price. So in this column, which is the latest? This is the latest. So this is called latest issue price. So 5 into 25 we are getting 125. Okay, now see the balance. How much balance will I have now? Issue columns, which method we have to follow now? We have to follow FIFO method now. So he is not saying from which date, right? So from 70 we are, suppose there is a shortage of 5, so we will write here 65 25. 65 into 25, we are getting 1625. Then same as it is, record same as it is as 380. Okay, 24.50, 380 into 24.50, 9310 we are getting. Done. This is only balance we are having. 70 to 25, 1750, 380, 24.50, 9310. This is not there, I strike off. Okay, next. This is our returns. Where to write this shortage in issue column and which price? Latest issue price. This is the latest issue price. Okay, got it? Chale, this I am writing here as shortage. So it will be easy to understand. Okay, here I have written return to supplier and here I have written shortage. Next, 22nd is done. Next, after which date? 25th. What we have done on 25th? Goods purchased. They have purchased 120 units. And on 25th, January, goods has been purchased. So purchased means receipt column, no purchased. 25th or 24th? 24th, sorry. Goods have been purchased 200 units at rupees 25.50. 200 units 25.50. So 200 units into 25.50, 5100. Okay, so the balance will be 65 into 25, we get 1625. Then 380, 24.50, 9310. Next, 200, 25.50, 5100. Done. Okay, so this is our what? 24th January received goods. Next, after that what? 25th January they have issued 120 units. 25th January they have issued. So how many units they have issued? 120 units. So no requisition number. Let me write here 120, because here only we are having 65. So we have to issue 120 units. So first issue 65 units. So 65 into 25, 1625. So we have to issue 120 units. So already we have issued 65. How much still we need? 55. From 380 we'll take 55. 55 into 24.50. Okay. 55 into 24.50. We are getting 1347.5. Okay. So 65 we have taken from FIFO, first he is here, and still we required 55. So we took from 380, 55 units we took, and the price is 24.50. So from 380 we have issued 55 units, so you will be balance will be 325. 380 minus 55. Okay, 325, then 24.50 multiply 325 into 24.50, you will get 79962.5, and the same balance 200 will be this as it is. 200, 25.50, 5100. Okay, chale. What is last now? Last is 26th January. What is the 26th January? Return to stores. Goods and returned on stores. When? Issued on 20th January. 20th January issued goods. That goods has come back. So whenever the goods are returned to stores, what you have to do? Returns to stores, you have to record as receipt column. You have to record as receipt column. And the information is given. What is the information? The price at which was issued. Which price was issued? On 20th January, we will see in solution. On 20th January, we have issued for rupees 25. On 20th January, we have issued for 25. That goods are coming back now to the stores. So, let me write here, 26th January, the goods are coming back. So, you have to record in receipt column. Because goods are returned to stores, you have to record in receipt column. How many goods are returned? 15 units. So 15 units, which price we have to take? So goods returned on 20th January. 20th January issued means these goods are coming back. So this price you have to take 25. So 15 into 25, 375. So in stores you are having goods 325. First, you are having this. The balance I am writing. 2.5. The balance I am writing, right? Next, 200. 25.50. 5100. Next is goods. These are you have received. It will be in the stores. 25,375. Okay, done. So your balance will be you do only the value total cost of material 7962.5 plus 5100 plus 375. So you are getting 7962.5 plus 5100 plus 375. 7962.5 plus 5100 plus 375. 13,437.5 is a closing value, and this is what return to stores. Done. So in this problem we have seen return to supplier. Whenever the goods are returned to supplier, you have to record in which column, issue column, and you have to record at which price it has purchased. The same price you have to write. Okay, I repeat, whenever the goods are returned to supplier, you have to record the units will be given in question. And he says you have purchased the goods which purchased on 10th January said. That goods you are giving returning, so you have to record in which column, issue column, and the price at which it was purchased. Okay, next, whenever the goods has been there is a shortage, if there is a shortage, you have to shortage amount goods quantity will be given, you have to record in issue column, record in issue column, and you have to take the price latest issue price. So here latest issue price is 25. Done. And whenever there is a return to stores, whenever there is a return to stores, you have to record in which column, received column. You have to record in which column, received column. So this is your received column. And at which price it says return to stores, he has given the goods which have issued on 15th January says. So that we have to record it here. We have recorded here. 20th January. This we have recorded. So the information will be given like this. We have to solve the problem. The closing stock is 13,437.5. Simple, very simple. You do practice this problem, you can easily solve it. Okay, so let me check a question in textbook. Either we have one FIFO or not, returns to stores. Here we are having LIFO one. What are you having? FIFO, I'll explain later. FIFO is there in the textbook. Questions are not good. Here is there. 22nd one. I want you to practice this 22nd one. Let me read once. The following is the extract of receipt and issue of supplier sulfur in a chemical factory during a month. He has given C. Opening balance he has given. Issue he has given. Issue he has given. Issue he has given. Received he has given. Return from department he has given. Department means what? Production department. So this is return to stores. Return to stores. Then again issue, received, issue, received, issue, return from department. Again it is return to stores. Return from which department? Production department. It means return to stores. Received is there, issued or priced on FIFO method. There is a verification on 10 January. Sequence you have to follow. After 8th you have to write this shortage. How much? 10 tons. And on 22nd left a note accordingly. Okay, no issue, no need. 10 tons on 22nd. 22nd means here, sorry, not 10th, this is 10 units. 22nd means 22nd is here, it comes on here. So after 20 you have to write shortage. After 20 you have to write shortage. Next, draw up a stores ledger card for the material showing the above transaction. And he has given what? The hint also, what he says. Material returned from department 15 should be valid at 200 per ton because the previous issue was a rate only. So here is given what? Hint also. I want you to check this. And you can solve it. Okay, this is FIFO method. 22nd problem you have to solve. It's very easy. solve this problem. That's enough. Solve 22nd problem with hint A is given. So I want you to solve FIFO method. Okay. Let's move to the LIFO method. There's a twist in the 20th question in LIFO method. I want you to solve. Okay, I'll solve the easy one. I want you to solve this 20 problem. Okay, next to 21, we'll see from here. One more example on LIFO, we'll see from here. Same is explaining here. Same is given, right? Almost same. 1000 units. Instead of 500, here he is saying 5000 units for 5 rupees. 500 units issued, again 300 units issued 9th January, 10th January received from supplier, and 15th January returned the goods which we have purchased on 3rd January, that has been issued, that has been returned to stores, which we issued on 30th Jan, which date? 3rd Jan, issued 480, 20th Jan, 24th Jan, purchased again, and 25th Jan issued, returned to stores again, here also store, okay. Next physical verification is done 20 Jan 22. Again, there is a shortage. So Jan 22, there is a shortage. So in between, in one entry, we have tried. Easy. Which method he is asking you to follow? LIFO method. This also solve. Okay. Then rest one question I want you to solve. So let us solve this example. Here I've drawn the format. Let me write the workings. The format I'll do complete first. So heading we know, we have tried the same heading as stores ledger LIFO method. That's it. No need of writing shortage, spoilage, and you know, shortage, surplus, or return to vendor, return to stores. No need of writing. The question which we are solving, that also asked in March, April 2017. Okay, so that heading will be stores ledger. Let me write here like this, page 1 and 2. It will be easy to send pick. This is 3 and 4. When I turn this, it will be on the same page I have drawn. So heading will be stores ledger. In brackets we'll write LIFO method instead of FIFO. LIFO method. Okay. Chali. First will be received, issued, last is balance. Okay, so first is here date, purchase order number, quantity, unit price, total here, requisition number, quantity, unit, total, quantity, unit, total. Chaliye, it's very easy. So there's opening balance on 1st January, there's opening balance. So let me write here 1st Jan. It's opening balance. Opening balance means we have tried in balance column. How many units? 1000 units at rupees 5 each. 5000. Okay. Next, 3rd June, we have issued 500 units. It's 3rd June. Sorry, 3rd Jan. Issued no requisition number. 500 units at rupees 2500. The balance will be 500. 5 rupees. 2500. Next, on 9th January again 300 issued. 9th January, no requisition number, 300 issued, 1500. The balance will be 200 with rupees 5, 1000. Done. Simple. Next. So Jan 9th, there is a January 10th received from supplier 400 units. Then on 10th January, received from whom? Supplier. So the purchase is 400 units at rupees 4.50. 400 into 4.50. So 1800 you are getting. Okay. So the balance will be your, what balance you are having now? 200 balance you are having. 5 rupees 1000. Then again you purchased 400 with 4.50. 1800. Okay. Chale, next. After which date? 10th, 15th, return to stores. On January 15th, return to stores. 15th Jan. Return to stores. How many units? 20 units. Returned means where you have to write? You have to write in issue column, right? Whenever the goods are returned, you have to write in which column? To stores. Goods are returned, you have to write in receipt column. Write in receipt column. How many units? 20 units. And what will be the price on which it was issued? It was issued on 3rd January. What is the price on 3rd January? 5 rupees. Write as 5. So 20 into 5. 100. As your balance will be 200, 5, 1000, 400, 4.50, 1800. And the same again, you will have this balance to 20, 5, 100. Okay. The goods which you have returned from stores, that you have to write as in balance, because you have this, you are recording as receipt. So return to stores. Okay. Chale, next. After that, again received, issued how many goods? 480 units. Date is what? 20 January. 20 January goods has been issued. So go to the requisition number. Units is 480. Issue 480. But you are having 200 first. So let us issue first 200 with 5 rupees 1000. From 480 you have issued 200. How much is left over? 280. 4.50 1260. Okay, so from 400 you have issued 280. 400 minus 280, 120 is balance. With 4.50, 120 into 4.50, you are having 540. Next, 20 as it is, 20, 5 rupees 100. Okay, 480 we need. We have give. Oh yeah, we have to give LIFO method, right? Oh. I followed FIFO. We have to follow LIFO. Shit. My goodness. So from 400 I have to issue. Entire wrong. What is happening? C says LIFO method and I am doing FIFO method. Shit. 20 January. So let me continue here. January issues how many? 480 we have to issue. Okay, continuation is here. So LIFO means first this 20 we have to issue with 5 rupees 100. Then we have to issue 480 means 380 we need now. We can issue from 400. 380, 4.50. We need 380, boss. 480 minus 20, 400 we can, entire 400 we can issue, because we need still 460 we need, but 400 we are having. God knows what is happening. 1800. Still we need how much? 20 plus 460. See, 400 we are issuing. 420. Still we need how much? 60 we more need. So 60 we are taking from 200. 60, 5 rupees, 60 into 5, 300. My mistake, my bad. This is not, you should not copy this, please. Okay. So we need 480. So first is we are having 20. So we issued 20. Then we still need 460. 460 we need, but we have 400. So we have issued 400. Then we need 60, we have taken from 200. Okay, so from 200 we have issued 60. How much is balance? 140 is a balance with rupees 5 to 5, 700. So we are having balance only 140 now. Next, next after that, Jan 22nd we have to do. 20 after 20 with 22nd. What we have done on 22nd, there is shortage of 5 units. 22nd January, and whenever there is a shortage, you have to record as an issue. There is shortage. How many shortage? How much is shortage? 5 units. Okay. And which price we have to take for shortage? For shortage, we have to take the price which it was latest issue price. Shortage. What is the latest issue price? See, what is the latest issue price for shortage? 5 is the latest issue price. For shortage, this is the latest issue price, so you have to take 5. 5 into 5 is 25. Okay. Now, so this is shortage. Let me write shortage. Whenever there is a shortage, you have to write in the issue column, you have to write the latest issue price as here. So from 140, you have 5 is gone. 140 minus 5. How much is left over? 135 with 5 rupees into 5 is 675. Okay, then next we'll move further. After that, what is that? 22nd, 24th, they purchased 200 units. 24th January, they have purchased how many units? 200 units at rupees 5.50. 200 into 5. 200 into 5.50. 1100. The balance will be 135 with 5 rupees. 5675. And 200 with 5.50. 1100. Okay. Next. After 24th. 25th January issued 120 units. 25th January issued how many units? 120. We have to issue 3R. I have written in which column, you know, requisition number column. Requisition. Date, purchase order number, unit quantity, price. Okay, it's fine. So confusing. How many units we have to issue? 120, right? 120. Can I issue from 200? Yes. So price is 5.50. Leave for it. $660. From 200 we issued 120. First let me write 135 as balance. Next, how much is left over? 200 we issued 120, so it is left over 5.50. 80 into 5.50, 440. So from 200 we issued 120. So first we have to write balance 135.5. To 200, 120, it is balance 5.50, 440. Next, after that, January 26th, return to stores 15 units. 26th January. We are returning to stores. Whenever there is a returning to stores, you have to record in purchase column. You have to record in receipt column. How many units? 15 units. But it is not being said. See, in the earlier problem, he said, in the earlier transaction, he said, whenever the goods return to stores, he has given the date on 3rd Jan. But here, it is not, date is not been given. So, whenever the goods are returning to the stores, information is not given. So, what we have to do? We have to take the latest issue price. We have to take the latest issue price. Here, right? Here is the latest issue price. So, in absence of information when it was issued, so what we have to take? We have to take latest issue price. What is the latest issue price? 5.50. So 15 into 5.50. It's very easy. Okay. So the balance will be 135 with 5 rupees, 675, 80 with 5.50, 440, and 15, 5.50, 82.5. The closing balance will be 675 plus 440 plus 82.5, 1197.5. This is our closing stock. Okay, done. This is return to stores. Okay, got it? Easy, chali, done. So 1197.5 is your closing stock. So like this you have to do FIFO method and LIFO method. Easy. So this you should understand first. This three is important: return to vendor, supplier, and shortage and surplus. Okay, so do practice with this. We have done this FIFO and LIFO method, shortage with shortage, surplus, vendor, and all. So you practice. I'll take from other from if you have CR publication, from that you see our different questions and practice. Okay, so with this I can say we have finished the syllabus. Left over is what? Process costing and overheads. Only these two units is left over, process costing and overheads. So I'll put that as revision. I'll complete that. Only two three problems I'll show, because we have done contract costing and here we have done labor. So overheads and process costing, only two or three problems I'll explain. Format based chapter, both overheads and job process costing is format based. So I'll explain two or three problems, then it will be easy. You can easily solve from these chapters. Introduction is questions I'll give you. Materials we have done, labor we have done perfectly, unit costing or output costing we have done in a proper way. Next, contract costing also we have done. So process and overheads is our choice. So process costing I'll explain, it's a format based chapter, it's very easy to solve. 1-2 problems I'll explain, and overheads also same, 1-2 problems I'll explain. Okay, if you do not do overheads also, it's easy, because a question will be asked from labor, compulsory question will be asked from labor. So I'll solve only problems from process costing. Easy, surely. So I can say our syllabus is done. Okay. So do problems. Sorry, one more problem I have to give you from LIFO, right? For materials I have to give for LIFO. Returns and all. This one you solve. 20th one you solve. It's very interesting. Very good problem. 20th one. Okay, returns. So next class is on next week. Do practice.